Hi, everyone. This is our weekly blog, and today I have with us Scott. Scott's from San Antonio, Texas, and he's doing rounds with us for a few days. And he's been watching the website, and he's been watching the blog questions. And I know there's somebody that asked a specific question, and he knows what it is, and he's going to ask me, and I'll try my best to answer it. Okay? Scott, you're up.
Yeah, Bob, somebody on the blog asked if you would mind talking a little more in depth about the pulses that are proximal to the chur going up the arm.
On both sides?
On both sides.
Okay. The pulses that are proximal to the chur position on the left and the right, there is a lot of information contained in those pulses. And you need to know or to learn, and you can start by memorizing what these pulses mean. First of all, let's take the right side, okay? Now, typically what you'll find in the chur position on the right side is very often you'll find a little mustard seed pulse. That's soft tissue damage in the shoulder, okay? And then you look proximal to that pulse and see if the mustard seed has a tail. Is the tail high up in the middle or low, okay? If the tail is wide, very ropey, wiry, and superficial and kind of pounding, these people almost always have neck issues and a very tight upper back and neck. And very often they'll have headaches. And so that you remember this, if they have that pulse on both arms, then they, and it's a man, they will have an enlarged prostate. If it's on a man or a woman, they also very possibly have a chemical poisoning in the body, kind of a low-level kind of chemical poisoning where they worked around fumes, gasoline, glue, electrical equipment, or something like that, and they get these low-level poisoning, they can have these kinds of Taiyang pulses on both sides. People who have been in the special forces, fired a lot of weaponry and smelled the cordite, they will get a slight poisoning in the system. Painters have it. Electricians have it. Okay, so that's what that is. That's a big ropey Taiyang pulse. It's not usually too deep. It's more middle to higher up.